I would describe Tony Tompkins as dedicated.
Interesting.
Professional.
He's fabulous.
I think it stems back from when I was a very young boy, and I'd always be watching movies or TV shows, and, you know, with my dad, my brothers, my mom, or whoever wanted to watch a film with me or a TV show, and, you know, I'd always see people, you know, one film and then in another film playing totally different characters. And I told my dad, and I go, "Hey, Dad, didn't this guy die? He was in this movie," or, you know. And he sat me down and he was like, "Anthony, listen. It's a fictional story, and there's characters, and, you know, they're called actors that play these characters, and they get to do many, many different roles and appear in many different films and TV shows." And you know, my eyes just wide open at this point, and, you know, from then on, I just was like, wow, I want to be able to do this.
Tony stood out as he had more visual, like, quirkiness about him.
I think I thought of him as very responsible, very, very intelligent.
When I first met Tony, I thought that he was pretty cool and very knowledgeable.
I remember one of the first few days when I had met Tony, that he walked into a room, started playing things on the piano, because it seemed like a strange thing to do, but I definitely wanted to get to know him better.
What do I like best about Tony? His honesty.
His sense of humor has to be the thing I like the best about him.
What I like best about Tony is how he exudes fun and positivity on set.
The thing that I like most about Tony is that he's really upfront and honest.
The thing that would intrigue me the most about Tony is, where does his motivation come from? Like, what caused him to be who he is today?
Alongside his mannerisms and his the way that he speaks, it's the way he gets excited about a film project.
What do I like most about my profession? I think it has to do with more or less that we can bring in an audience into our world, into our minds, and, you know, take them away from their reality for, you know, however long our story runs, and, you know, they forget about their worries, they forget about their troubles, and, you know, they either laugh, they cry, and, you know, feel that anxiety of suspense, you know, the thriller, the horror, and, you know, bring them out of their world and putting them into ours and making them feel that passion that we feel for it. I think it's an absolutely brilliant thing that we do. That's just it. There's always obstacles, no matter where we go, what we do, and, you know, growing up in the town, which I did, there's not much in the arts field. I mean, they keep trying to make it arty, but they don't necessarily touch home to a lot of what's going on in such of my life, for example, probably tons of other people, where, you know, they want to make films, you know, they want to be filmmakers, they want to be actors, they want to be directors, but, you know, they don't tend to have that, and being faced with that and with no acting training courses or anything of that nature for the longest time, until I was later in my life, and I've already made up my decision to basically move across country and pursue my career in film.
I would like to say that Tony is super fun to work with, and he's just all around a really good guy.
When looking at the location, I couldn't help but think to myself about how Tony acts on set and his professionalism, and he's been an influence with regards to how I see myself professionally.
If I could add anything about Tony, it's that I look forward to working with him again in the future, just again and again.
He's fun to have a drink with.
Any advice I could give to aspiring filmmakers? Let's see. See, I believe that we need to reach inside ourselves and be able to find the story, and our minds become the camera and our eyes are the lens to that camera. And you know, if you can tap into that sort of mindset and be able to tell a good story, no matter what genre you're trying to get into or become a master of, I think that if you can become a part of the story yourself and be able to relate to the story more or less, you'll be a success.